So in the last unit, we talked about the simple algorithms for our three problems that have to go through an exponential number of solutions to try all possible assignments of 0 and 1 to the vertices. And now I haven't told you yet what this super powerful computer down here in the left corner is actually capable of. And the ability that this computer here has is that it can help us figure out the best possible 0 and 1 assignment to the vertices without actually going through them. And the way this computer can help us is that it has a special instruction that a normal computer or even the RAM model does not have. And that instruction is called if better. And I'm going to explain to you in a second what that means. So the if better function basically works like a normal if else instruction on the RAM. So the normal if else instruction is, if this part here, which I haven't specified yet, is true, then this part of the code that you've written is executed, and otherwise this part down here is executed. The second property is that calling the if better function costs us polynomial time. So a normal if else on the RAM just costs one time step or constant time, and calling this function here will cost polynomial time. And now here comes the special property of this function. Normally when you have an if, you would have to specify some condition here so that if the condition is satisfied, this part of the code is executed. And if it's not satisfied, then this part here is executed. Now the if better is a function that will figure out by itself if it's better for us, and I'm going to show you in a minute what I mean by that, if it's better for us to execute this part up here or this part down here. It will always, if you will, guess correctly which part of the code to execute. Now, the first time you hear this, it takes a bit getting used to. So let me give you one example for vertex cover, how we could use this powerful function to solve vertex cover almost trivially.